Such a happy occasion. I'm delighted, absolutely delighted to meet you. And to hear what our young cadets have said here, it's so encouraging. It gives you confidence. And in fact, in your remarks, you are very young, but in your remarks, you have laid bare the secret of the longevity and continuity of Indian civilization. There were older civilizations than India, but those civilizations are today subject of the study of archaeologists, whereas Indian civilization is a continuing and living entity. What is the secret? I do not know if you consciously did it, but you have spelled it out. You said that we met cadets from other parts of the country, different backgrounds, cultural, lingual, social, that gave an opportunity to you to learn so many things from this interaction, and they surely must have learned from you. Only yesterday at a function I said that we have a story which says there is a mythical tree which is called Kalpataru. The quality of Kalpataru is that whatever you wish, it fulfills your wish. But there is a crow who sits on Kalpataru, and the name of the crow is Kak Bhushandi. And Kak Bhushandi says, you know how the crow, the voice of the crow, you know, ka, ka, ka. So ka in Sanskrit can be, it is an exclamation, it is an interrogation, it is, can be translated as why, what, and maybe how as well. Basically, it raises the question. And one of the earliest names which Indians gave to God was Ka. What it shows? It shows the keenness, the curiosity to learn new things, ever devoted to the pursuit of knowledge, tapa swadhyay nirittam, ever devoted to the pursuit of knowledge. Why? In fact, it has been described that the purpose of life is acquisition of knowledge. Why acquisition of knowledge? Because it is through the instrumentality of knowledge that we are able to, we can succeed in removing the layers of ignorance under which is buried the divinity which is inherent in every being. And when that divinity manifests itself, then all these differences disappear. The differences are only, India has always believed. The civilizational journey of India started. Ekam sad vipra bahuda vadanti. The truth is one. Those who know it, they describe it variously. You are, as NCC cadets, I'm so happy that you met our chiefs of the Navy and our Prime Minister, Defense Minister, other people. Here the defense officers are also sitting. It's a fact. This is not to please them. This is not to please you. We sleep comfortably in the night because of you. It is not possible that we are able to express our gratitude to you by simple words. It can only be felt. How grateful the whole nation is to you. We are a country since eternal times, remotest times. Our ideal is peace. Our ideal is non-violence, non-injury. Then young minds, this confusion can come that if we are wedded to peace, if we are wedded to peace, why we need this huge structure of the defense force? This is, be clear. Our ancient tradition tells us, agrata chaturo veda, prashta sasharam dhanu. Shastradi, shastradi. You should be well equipped with knowledge. But you should also have the weapons. In order to repel the aggressor, first use every possible peaceful means. Those peaceful means can happen only if you are armed with knowledge. Veda is not simply those four books which are storehouse of wisdom. Vid means to know, acquisition of knowledge. That only motivates you to go further. That is the beginning of the journey, not the end of the journey. But then, if the aggressor persists, then you should also be in a position where you can use the force to repel the aggressor. Non-violence should not be confused with lack of courage. Non-violence means absence of hatred. We do not hate even those who are the aggressors. But we have a duty to defend ourselves. Non-violence means absence of fear. The word abhi, abhi, not just abhe, abhi, has been used repeatedly in our ancient books. You have to be abhi, fearless. Why? Because we believe this is one of the core teachings of Indian philosophy. Why there is so much emphasis on, we are human beings. We face so many dangers, so many challenges. Fear is a natural instinct. But it has been repeatedly emphasized to shed fear. Be abhi. Why? Because one of the cardinal features of the Indian philosophy is, I am not my body. If I believe that I am this body, then this is avidya, ignorance. ഐ എം ചേതന്യ ആത്മ കോൺഷ്യസ് സോൾ ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് സോൾ നോബഡി ദിസ് സോൾ ഡസ് നോട്ട് ടേക്ക് ബർത്ത് ദിസ് സോൾ ഡസ് നോട്ട് ഡൈ ഇറ്റ് ഓൺലി കീപ്സ് ചേഞ്ചിങ് ഫോംസ് ദെയർഫോർ നോ നീഡ് ടു ഫിയർ ഐ ഹാവ് റെസ്പോൺസിബിലിറ്റി We must also be clear. So many things have, over a period of time it happens, the way we need every morning to have bath, to clean our body, we also need to refresh our thinking, because many a times distortions come. So I would say, I'm so impressed by whatever you have spoken, and the manner in which I am hearing you are coughing. So it's not only that you were, Secretary Saab rightly pointed out to me, because you are not used to this cold of Delhi. So it is good that you have been exposed to the cold of Delhi. You must know that in your country, there are parts where for about 2 months, 3 months, it is severe cold. Then there are other parts where the spell of the cold is much longer. So I am really very happy, absolutely delighted to meet you. Happy to know about your performance, happy to know about your experiences in Delhi. And meeting you gives us confidence that it is that to future we can look with optimism, with the confidence that we will be in safe hands. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.